So only aspiring pop stars to remain here.
Long
That's the one
shot,
rule.
but I'm willing to try.
Oh, I'm looking forward. Do you all have instruments with you, or you all play instruments? Yes. I'm trying to see everyone here. That it's on two pages. Do you have your instruments with you? Can I get thumbs up if you do? Yes, I see some violins. I see
And
some
Robert,
thumbs
there's
up.
two people coming in. So some of us are there to learn. Some of them are there to play along, but there's two people coming in. So
Okay, yeah, I see there's. We have more joining. Okay, well, can someone let me know when we have the majority of
when
people? Like,
I
is it
think
a.
we give a, we start no matter what at 5 minutes after.
5 minutes after.
So yeah,
Okay,
if it's a,
okay.
that's what we've been doing this morning too, if that's all right for you.
Yeah, that's great. I'm just
We
going to
also
take a
let
minute.
people, yeah, exactly. I mean, you can just ease into it as you like.
Sure, I'll just take a minute to. I'm setting up one of the folders together with Sam, who's here. If you can see Sam, he's with the vertical video. He's
Yeah,
an
we
amazing
saw him.
bassist, and he will be helping out with the video and the editing and everything that goes into that. So he's a very techie guy. And so we're just setting up the logistics for that.
Perfect.
So
Just
I'll just take a minute for that.
perfect, dude. Yes. Sam is now co-organizer, and I think that some people got shy.
In the meantime, I can share again our poll, our welcome poll link. And so if after this session you go to this link you see in the chat, you can answer to the question, what are you hoping for from the Sello Summer Fest? So we have gathered few answers till now, and you can add yours.
More coming in. I think it's a little bit of a Venezuelan mode of joining adagio, eh? Being which originally means at ease, you know? So so they're joining at ease.
Is that the whole the festival? Is that in Venezuela?
We are no, we are based in this morning we had a roundup of where we were. We're all over Europe sort of so far. I think we may do again a geographical pinpointing. I'm in the north of Italy, but Elisabetta is in the south of Italy.
Ah, nice. I'm from Germany.
So, okay, I think if they come late, it's sort of their problem.
Okay,
Yeah, I
well,
think we can
hello.
start.
Yes, let's get this going. We don't have so much time, and there's a lot of pop
Exactly.
music to get through. It's only four chords though, so don't worry. It's always very simple in some ways, but there are different kind of challenges you have with pop music. So yeah, if I could have as many of you with the video on, and maybe if you have your instrument to just have it ready as well. Be nice to see some faces. Yes, hello. Okay, I'll just hide the chat
Hi.
so I get the bigger screen. Okay. Yeah, so has everyone seen the sheet music? Have you received a link with it? And will you have a way to look at it while using the Zoom as well?
Yes.
Will you have that option? Because I'll want to just go through the song with you. And maybe we play together without hearing each other, but I have like a guide track that I've created for you. But yes, so the thing I wanted to tell you a bit about how I got into playing pop and how it has changed over the past kind of 5 to 10 years, where it was almost like a taboo subject for classical musicians to play pop music and kind of seen as a, selling out kind of thing. to now being such a big part of the classical repertoire and the concerts and the recordings that come out. So it's, we definitely have to embrace it, and there's so much great music there. And if it's, it's more about the quality whenever you do something to really have it, to nail it, and to, no matter what genre you play, and to just get the right feeling for it. Yeah, and the song that we will work on is, as you know, is Driver's License by Olivia Rodrigo. It's the biggest song of the year. And I thought it works quite well for arranging and for like a orchestral sound. And yeah, therefore I've created this score. It is, we have a very top heavy orchestra here of mainly violinists. And but I think it'll be fun because let me tell you a bit about how we'll do this. So we're not going to record anything on Zoom. What we'll do is we'll get each of you individually to record the part while listening to a click track, kind of a guide track. And because that way then we can put it all together and create a video. And that's very difficult to do on Zoom because of latency and because of all kinds of messy things. Can I just see all the people with cameras off? Are you here? Can you give a sign of life? And whether you have, whether you're going to play? Yeah. Are you going to participate? If you're going to film yourself performing, can you give me what emojis do we have? Let's have a... Can you give me a heart if you're going to play, if you have an instrument? Okay, we have one heart. How many players do we have? Two. Am I seeing everyone here? I think so. Okay.
I think not everybody knows about the hearts because I see someone with a fiddle who hasn't put up
yes,
a
yes,
heart.
Yes, okay, no, that's sure. So I just want to roughly see what we have. Okay, one.
So I am sort of co-hosting this, and
okay,
yeah. So I'm not playing, but yeah.
Okay.
And
oh, we have a. Is that a tuba? Or was it
yes,
a big?
A small tuba. Euphonium.
A small tuba. Okay. Well, let me know if do you have sheet music, because
no.
I can create you a part. You can play the cello part or something maybe. Yeah. Okay, I'll put in the chat right now for anyone who doesn't have the sheet music. You can find the closest instrument if your instrument isn't there. So I'll put it in the link, and that's going to be an important link because that's where everything will happen. That's, we have three folders there. Oh, sorry, I think I gave the wrong link. Well, that was bad. I'll put that another link. Okay, here. So this is the link. Yes, and you have three folders there. If you go in the sheet music, if you don't have sheet music, you can find it there. Okay. Has everyone heard the song? Should we have a listen to it together? And maybe we'll listen to a little bit so we get an idea of it, and then we'll look at the sheet music together and kind of go through it, because with pop music it tends to sound much simpler than it looks on the sheet music, because it doesn't translate so easily on paper. So yeah, let's have a listen. I'm going to try and share my audio. Advanced. Okay. Can you hear this?
Got my driver's license last week, just like we always talked about. Cause you were so excited for me to finally drive up to your house. But today I drove through the suburbs, crying cause you weren't around. And you're probably with that blonde girl who always made me doubt. She's so much older than me. She's everything I'm insecure about. Yet today I drove through the suburbs, could I ever love someone else? And I know we weren't perfect, but I've never felt this way for no one. And I just can't imagine how you could be so okay now that I'm gone. Guess you didn't mean what you wrote in that song about me. 'Cause you said forever, now I drive alone past your street. And all my friends are tired.
Okay, so you get the idea. That's the beginning. It has a second part as well, which is kind of the more loud and exciting bit. But let's just maybe have a look at it together. I'll share with you now the score that I have. And you'll see that the writing is, it looks quite complicated, but it really isn't. It's just because it's all kind of syncopated rhythms, all ties, and you always get that with pop music. One thing I learned when I did my first sessions recording pop songs was that you kind of shouldn't follow the score too closely, because it won't have the most important ingredients. It's better to know the song and to really kind of get the general picture of the song there and then just follow it rather than sticking to the score, because then it can sound very kind of very basic, and it kind of, if you play it in a kind of classical way, then you won't get the pop feeling and you'll be missing the point. So yeah, I'll show you the score now. Desktop to share. Can you all see this? Screen's quite big. So I've put here piano part. Do we have a piano player, actually? Because I saw someone had said that they're a pianist or a clarinet player. But it's okay. Well, I can record the piano as well. But yeah, so here's the score. And I thought those of us who have instruments, maybe we can, I'll play the score. And we can play along with it and just go through it and see how it goes. Do you all have your parts ready to follow it? You can also try and... Oh no, someone has it on their phone. Well, how about, can you follow from this screen? Does that work? I don't know how clear it is.
It's very clear.
It's very clear. Okay, good. Because yeah. There is a, there's the violins there, trumpet. I think that should be in B flat, but I don't know if we have a trumpet player here. So there's viola, cello, double bass. I think we're mostly violins and the tuba. So if that works. Okay, I'm going to just try and see if the sound here will come through to Zoom. Okay. Oh. Zoom loop back. Okay. Can you tell me if you can hear something? In a second. Sorry. I'm going to. Where is Zoom? Sorry, my Zoom has minimized to this. I need to.
Maybe it's better if you stop sharing for a moment and.
Sharing, okay. Okay, here we go. So I want to share my screen and the audio from. Is it possible to do both at the same time?
I think okay, so.
Let's put desktop 2 and share sound. Okay. So now you can see it, right? You can see the score. Let me know when you can hear it.
Yeah.
Can you hear it?
We can also hear.
You can also hear. Wow, that's amazing. I don't know if I can hear it, but... just a second. I will, because I want to hear as well. Let's put it. Okay. Can you still hear?
No.
Okay, well, I'll put it back there. That will be the only option. Okay. You can hear now. Okay, and the... So we will go from the beginning. Let me put this down. And just follow the score along. I'll mute my microphone as well, and I'll play along. You can pick the part that you have been assigned. And let me know, is this a good, should I zoom in a bit more? Is this clear?
It looks really, the score is perfectly fine. That's a bit too big because we're seeing your top of your screen as well. Uh-huh. But I wanted to ask, do you have, is it possible to make it a bit louder? Because I feel if I play with it, I'm not
going to
hear a lot. Thank you.
So I'm going to make it as loud as possible. And I'll only have the bass and the piano for us to listen to because they're kind of, we don't want all to be playing, doubling with everything. Oops. Okay, how is the volume now? I think that's as loud as I can get.
Okay, it's a bit better, yeah. Maybe so I'll get headphones. That
yeah, probably headphones are the best for this.
Okay.
Okay. If anyone needs to grab headphones, now's the time. And our tuba player is happy with the cello part. Yes, okay. What's your C? What clef does the tuba? Is it bass clef?
Yes, for tuba is bass clef, but for euphonium in B flat is a treble clef.
Treble clef?
Yes, but it's all right. I can read
okay.
it.
Okay. I can make a part after if you want.
No, I don't need. I can read each
okay,
part
okay.
you want or... I can transpose, so.
Nice, that's a very valuable skill that violinists never have to learn, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Okay, do we have people ready? Ready to rock?
Yes.
Yes, okay. I'll play this and I'll mute my microphone, which I hope still means you can hear the computer sound.
I don't hear anything.
Robert, I think we can't hear. If you mute yourself.
Okay, so if I mute myself, you don't hear me. Okay. So I will not be playing, only you'll be playing. Okay, let's go. Okay. How did everyone find that? Yeah. Was there anything? Let me know if there's any problems or any errors. But yeah, so let's go to the beginning. So I will, the way we will record it is everyone will record separately. But I will send you this guide track as a as something to follow. You won't have the green line going through, so you'll need to follow the sheet music, but it's fairly straightforward. And yeah, I might record myself just playing one of the lines as well to go along, because if we did this live, which would be amazing, and hopefully we get the chance at some point, but to really play together in a section, you always see what everyone's doing and you can easily follow people. Whereas here we'll do it very individually. So when it all comes together, it might be, we each might have an amazing performance, but when put together, it's very different. So yeah, I'll record the first violin or second violin parts, and then to record on top of that. And so that's kind of the task that I want to give you all to, between this session and the next session, to have a go at recording it and filming yourself playing your part. Because in the next session, I also will want to spend some time on thinking about what else we have in the video, because I'm sure all of you have seen hundreds of collage online orchestras over the last year. And I think everyone has probably seen enough of them. So I think to take the concept a bit further, I think if we add some additional footage where if we take the theme of Seyo and on Europe and kind of how we all come from different backgrounds and sort of the Sistema philosophy to perhaps film something around your home country. I don't know where everyone's from here, but to really just kind of embrace the different backgrounds and where we all come from. And yeah, I thought we'd have a bit more players. So we might need to recruit some friends to beef up the virtual orchestra. So otherwise it'll be a chamber performance. But we'll see if we can do that also for Friday. But yeah, what should we? So let's Robert? Have a chat. Yep. Hello.
Sorry. Yes. Apologies because I have been moving and there was a bit of noise. I wanted to ask you. We have actually also expected to have. Quite a lot more players. That's why I was saying to getting somebody got shy or Tim or, you know, we go cold feet or whatever. Yeah. What can we do to catch up with them and to give them the chance to come back in? Maybe what wasn't completely clear with them is that unless you hear this, it's going to be very difficult to participate in the next one. Sure. Or, you know, try to yes, indeed, maybe round up some friends. That's certainly a good idea, and we can liaise about that. But how about, as we would say in Italian, fishing up some of the ones that we have lost? Because, for instance, we got a few messages saying, I'm sorry, this came up, or I had the COVID vaccine, I'm not feeling well, and things like that. But overall, I think it's much more that they suddenly get shy. And so if we can reassure them and try to bring them back in. Can I leave you with that thought as well?
Definitely. And, I mean, there's safety numbers. So there's the more of us there is, the less shy you will be. And it'll be like a common effort. And I think it will be fine if someone joins on Friday. I can do a quick recap of this. And if they have the music and they can download the guide track, then we can catch up with them on Friday. And yes, so I think it's fine, because I don't expect to have everyone to have sent in the footage before the next workshop, because, but I just thought it could be great to have some of it to get an idea of what we're working with and to then expand on that, because it's with these kind of things, it's always good to meet the people and then have a chat and see what we can come up with together, rather than have a idea in mind that might not work then. So just, yeah, wanted to put a face to everyone, to all the names. Yes, so, and as far as the filming goes, do you all have experience filming your own performances, and is that a thing? Can I get a thumbs up if you do? Have you had to do that this past year? I'm sure, hello, some new faces. Because it's a very important part of this, and it doesn't have to be a professional video, and you know, you don't have to use a camera, and using your phone is completely fine, but it's just setting it up for the best result to have interesting or good background, and to have light on yourself, and yeah, so then when we put it together, it can be such a variety of different videos, but they'll work together because everyone's, you know, taken care with it. And yes, if you do have any more professional equipment like these kind of things, which is my microphone, you're very welcome to use it for cameras, and yeah, to really find a good background and light where you can record together. Okay, I will, just so on the thought that we're all playing in kind of a similar way, I thought maybe I will play some of it to you or with you. Maybe you can play along, because it is, as I said, when you listen to the song, the actual original song, it sounds very different than how it looks on the score or how Sibelius performs it. It's very square, and we really want to try and get a nice flow and not be too kind of metronomical, because we're playing with the click track. It's kind of one of the dangers that can happen. Of course, there's the other extreme when you're listening to a full orchestral sound, which has a metronome, and you play along with that. You think, oh my gosh, this sounds amazing. And then you're not actually hearing yourself. So that was one thing that they taught me at school here in UK in music technology. Do not give your players the original song to play to, because they will think they sound amazing, but they won't be listening to themselves because they're just having so much fun. And just give them a click track so they're more kind of critical, and they have to create it rather than just surf on top of what's already existing. That's why I have this really basic piano track for you guys, so you can give it soul. But yeah, so let's have a play a bit with the melody, because I think everyone gets the melody at some point. And I imagine in the video, rather than it being all of us playing together all the time, it will kind of pass on from one person to another or something like that. So we'll see. Let's just maybe get our instruments, those of us who have them, and play with me. Tell me how the sound is as well, because it's very hard for me to guess if I'll be playing along, if it's all clear. Okay. Do stop me if the sound is terrible, or if you can't hear me, or if my playing's terrible. Thank you. How's the sound? Is it okay? Can you, is it clear?
It's very good, I think, actually, considering
that we are on
Zoom. Yes.
Okay, good, because I can't really hear the accompaniment very much. But yeah, so in the melody, we want to really kind of flow over the click, kind of. Like, imagine singing it. It's, you wouldn't ever think that it looks like a monstrosity like that. And this is exactly what you get when you try to write out your pop song parts. And sometimes people do it very simply. And then if the performer takes it literally, if you play what's on the score, it will just sound like a... So we don't want that. We want to find that way where it swings and it has a nice feeling. Do you all want to play along? Does it feel possible? I don't know if I'm in time with the guide truck, but let's just have a go. I think I see we have a cello. We have a new participant. And yeah, the cello also gets the melody a bit later. Do you have the score printed? Yes, okay, good. There's some things that I wanted to point out in the cello specifically. Sorry, just give me a second. Because in the original song, they have these glissandos. If we all listen together.
I got my driver's license last week, just like we always talked about. Cause you were so excited for me to finally drive up to your house. But today I drove through the suburbs, crying cause you weren't around. And you're probably blonde.
Could you hear that? Is it a... I wasn't just miming here by myself.
Yeah. No, good.
Yeah, we can hear.
This is so complex. But yes, so they have these glissandos at the end of the verse, which I think are in the score. And they're kind of your moment as well, because I think we have one cello in the whole orchestra. Yeah, so let's have a go and play it together. I'll put again the piano parts and bass. And I'll try and keep up here. Because my, believe it or not, my sound comes out of here for some reason for this Zoom thing to work. Okay. So let's have a play together. I'll play the first or second violin part. Okay.
Thank you.
Well done, everyone. I'm sure you're sounding great. You're looking great. Okay. So let's talk a bit about the logistics of when you'll have to film this and how to get it to me and Sam, who is also here, and he'll be helping with all the kind of submissions and things. So I sent you in the chat before the link with, I think I can stop sharing this for a sec. I sent you a link, the second one. And if you go there, I can actually share this maybe so I can show you. You don't have to go there now if you don't want.
I'll just send it again so they can see.
Okay, yeah. So let me also share my, where is this? I have a very first world problem. I have two displays, so I keep losing my mouse. I can't see where it goes. It runs off. Oh, you've shared it again. Okay, that's it. Okay, so here we can see. Can you see the screen? So we made three folders here with Sam, and here's all the sheet music if you need. There's the name of the things. I might also add the score, so it could be helpful. But so if you go back here, it's empty, but I will put the guide track, an MP3 file. So you will need to figure out the logistics for having your camera, your phone running, and you'll need to have headphones. So the guide track will have to be playing from your computer or something else, because you won't be able to film with the phone and listen at the same time, I think, because it's important that you have headphones.
The guide track, is it going to be you playing, or is it going to be the Sibelius?
So the guide track will be the piano on the Sibelius, and I think I'll record something as well.
I think if you record it, it's going to be very helpful, because we can hear the dynamics and the, you know.
So I'll record the first violin, or maybe first and second violin parts. But you must remember that you should have one ear free, so you can you hear yourself, because otherwise if you think I'm playing, because that's the kind of thing where you need to keep a clear head with a click track and hear yourself as well. That makes for the best recordings. So you'll need to have headphones. Ideally just in one ear or something like this, what I'm doing now, and you'll play the guide track. It will have like one or two bars before the playing starts. I think I'll make it like this, or I'll add another bar because I feel like this is a bit hectic. But yes, so you'll hear the two bars of this, of just piano. And then you start playing. Sorry, that was very loud. Yes, and then you will, let's go back there. So when you make your video, when you've recorded it, you can then go to this folder and you go in the video uploads, and this should be, you should be able to upload it inside here. And so all the submissions we can put here, it will be amazing. I don't know how full the schedule is for Sistema today or tomorrow, but if you could have a go before the next session on Friday, and if we can just have something done, because then on Friday we can also concentrate on maybe filming some other bits, because if we hear the pop song once again, they have some cool sounds there, which we can then kind of use if we go.
What you wrote in that song about me. You said forever, now I drive alone past your street. And all my friends are tired.
Can you all hear that? Yeah, is it all there?
Hearing how much I miss you, but I kind of feel sorry for them, because they'll never know you the way that I do. Yet today I drove through the suburbs.
Or we can then, on Friday, we can figure out this, some kind of string percussion or hitting your tuba or whatever works. And because it's, we got to remember this, if we'll be putting this on social media. So almost more important than the sound and the performance is also the presentation and kind of the visual side of it. Because it's, I mean, I don't know if you've seen also my arrangements. I try to make them impressive in terms of music, but also impressive in terms of if anyone just stumbled across it on Facebook or Instagram, would they stop to watch it? Because it's kind of, it has to be eye-catching. And I think it's little things like adding percussion or everyone being involved and, you know, being smiling when you're performing, to like looking like you're enjoying it. That's a very important one. That can really help. So yeah, that's kind of my advice for the filming side of it. If you do you have any questions? Have you done this kind of things before? Is it all clear? Yeah. The people with cameras off, are you here? Can we? Yes, someone's there. Someone from Wales, I'm guessing. And you're also going to record and participate?
We have also a message from Sam. He says, hello everyone, I'm just in the car, so it's very noisy, but if you have any questions about anything technical or you want any help with filming, please don't hesitate to get in touch with me or Robert. So thank you, Sam.
Yeah, absolutely. We put an email in there as well. So I'll put mine and Sam's email. Let's find Sam's email. Yes. So it would be amazing to, if there's any footage already, you know, tomorrow or something, to see if you can already upload it, and then we can see where we are at and what and how much we also need to recruit other musicians, because it would be nice to beef up the numbers and to really have a big splash when we make the video, and to have everyone involved. So that's I put my and Sam's emails in the chat, so feel free to message us, and yeah, we'll try and answer all your questions. Yes, and you have the Google Drive link there as well.
Mm-hmm. Let's, thanks.
Oh no, I'm sorry. Yeah, that's all good. I'm going to just play the chorus section now, actually, because we never got to that of the actual song, and I will share you the score. Share screen. Okay. So this is where you all have to go crazy and have to also look like you're loving it, because, you know, if you look like you're having fun, it sounds five times better. That's I want a lot of enthusiasm here. So let's hear it.
No, we weren't perfect, but I've never felt this way for no one. Oh, and I just can't imagine how you could be so okay. Now that I'm gone, I guess you didn't mean what you wrote in that song about me. You said for forever, now I drive alone past your street. Red lights, stop signs, I still see your face in the white cars. I've never felt this way for no one, and I just can't imagine how you could be so okay now that I'm gone. 'Cause you didn't mean what you wrote in that song about me. 'Cause you said forever, now I drive alone past your street. Yeah, you said forever, now I drive alone past your street.
Okay, there you go, the biggest song of the year, and maybe we'll get it back to number one with our recording. Yeah, that's the plan. Aim for the sky. Hello. Yes. So, I mean, I'm just now thinking about it. we could have also played with the pop song as a guide track, but I do think we would end up listening more than we to Olivia than ourselves. And so we need to try and work with the score, and but still have a free, flexible feeling and put some soul into it. And yes, let's see what you guys send me. Hopefully we have some submissions before the next session, and then we can see from there. We'll come up with some. I'll give a recap to any new people, and we will also think about a kind of a storyline for our video, because it's great if it's a throughout the whole thing, it's a collaborative effort, and we film a bit of our home country or something, film ourselves driving in a car or record some sounds like in the beginning of the song, they use the engine starting.
Roberts, may I?
Yep.
Sorry. So technically we should be finishing the session. I was wondering if this recap that you wanted to do before the other could take the shape of something that we could actually circulate before, because I think the format is very, very original. And I think probably there is some need to digest it. And if people go into it cold, I'm not sure that we get the very best result. Also in motivating people, okay, not to be scared, and what you say, safety in numbers. So I wonder if you could do like a, 3 minutes or something like that. I'm just speaking off the cuff, I'm just trying to, yes, to think what could work best. Which,
sure,
it will work, anything will work, but how we could maximize the impact of your commitment, effort, and talent, and have as many people playing as possible. And if they can get more into the dough, as we say in Italian, then it might be more reassuring.
Definitely, yes. So what do you guys think? Would, because in my mind, I feel if I just saw a video where I have to watch it and there's lots of instructions, it might be actually more daunting than being on a Zoom call. But I don't know, actually. What do you guys think? Should I do like a 10 minute rapid fire thing of the next session and bring everyone up to date? Or should we circulate a checklist?
How about thinking it over for a moment, we let it settle for a moment, but sure, the bridging to the purposes, bridging between this session and the other in a way that people feel confident, because I think there was so much enthusiasm about being there, and then there was somehow shyness, as I said. So to help them through, those who were there to consolidate and those who weren't there to round them up.
For sure. Okay, yes. So I'll have a think.
And think, if you could think about it, of course, it doesn't have to be. It was just as we were all here together now, mm-hmm, I thought I might suggest it.
Definitely. No, that's very helpful. Great. Well, nice to see you all. And I look forward to hearing you and playing together with you.
I want to learn the violin before tomorrow, actually. yes. No, I did a bit of violin, then I switched to piano seriously, but it makes me feel like wanting to play.
You could. you could throughout the most of the song get away with this.
Oh yeah, I have to. I borrow violin then.
There's a lot of suspensions, and that's one of them.
Good. Thank you.
Well,
thank you, Robert.
See you all on Friday, and go recruit your friends.
Yes.
I'll also yes, get more people. So we have a proper orchestra, and a bit of representation from all instruments and backgrounds. Great.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. See you on Friday.
See you on Friday.
If you have any questions, you can email me or Sam. Get in touch. Great.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Okay, great. So has everyone got their instruments with them? And do you have you found your parts? I think for some violinists, I didn't specify the parts, so you could just pick whatever you feel like. And yeah, because I think it would be nice to just go through quickly again the song and what we're going to do. So yeah. The song that we're working on is Driver's License by Olivia Rodrigo. It's kind of the biggest song of the year. And the idea is that we each record a separate part and then put it all together in one big video. And since it's impossible to do it live in Zoom like this, it'll be a complete mess. I need everyone to record one, and then I will be putting them together. And creating hopefully a masterpiece by next week with some sleepless nights. So has everyone heard the song? Let's have a quick listen to it. I'm gonna just play it a bit on Spotify. Probably breaking a lot of copyright laws there, but nothing new for me. okay. So let's find this song. Let me know if you can hear it.
I got my driver's license last week, just like we always talked about. 'Cause you were so excited for me to finally drive up to your house. But today I drove through the suburbs crying. You weren't around, and you're probably with that blonde girl who always made me doubt. She's so much older than me, she's everything I'm insecure about. Yet today I drove through the suburbs, 'cause how could I ever love someone else? And I know perfect, but I've never felt this way for no one. And I just can't imagine how you could be so okay now that I'm gone. Guess you didn't mean what you wrote in that song about me. 'Cause you said forever, now I drive alone past your street.
And then it repeats the whole thing, and we get to the climax.
Sidewalks we cross, I still hear your voice in the traffic. We're laughing over all the noise. God, I'm so blue, no, we're through, but I still fucking love you, babe.
Some profanities there, I apologize. So yeah, the song is actually very simple in its structure and chords. It's really just four chords. And I think it's more the kind of the lyrics of it and the personality of the singer that made it such a success. So I think that's one thing that's really important in pop music. It's always kind of the, not only the music, but it's also the story or the kind of meaning you add to it with visual elements or kind of, something extra. It has to pop. You need to have something that sets it apart. And yeah, that's why I think it's important to approach it in a different way than playing classical music and playing classical pieces. And if you've seen the sheet music, you will have noticed that it may look a bit kind of messy. Like the way you can write out a pop song isn't always, it doesn't always look like how it sounds. So it has all these ties all the time. It's all syncopated. Everything is off beats. And it's, if you didn't know the song and you looked at the piece, you think it's just something quite complicated, but I promise you it's not. And it's just really getting that freedom and the feeling of it to play it as if you weren't looking at the sheet music, as if you were just singing it. And, you know, it was just a simple thing. I'm going to share the screen now with the Sibelius score, which I hope you can all see. Can you? I see some nods.
Yeah, we see okay.
It. Yeah, we see it.
And yeah, should we have a go? And you can look at this score or your own score. We can just play to ourselves. We can just go through it and just see and try and find that freedom. So it's not it's not necessarily the notes there, but it's more the song that we heard a minute ago, and to really find the flow of it. Yeah, I'm gonna share my sound again. Ooh, how's it gonna work? Sorry. And yeah, we can, let me know if you can hear the Sibelius. There's always something that goes wrong. Can you hear that?
No.
No, you don't hear that.
Okay. Not yet.
Okay, I'm going to put this here. So you probably get. Can you hear that?
Yes.
Okay.
Great. Yes. So
if you can, everyone just mute microphones and play along, and we just go through the score. And then we can see, you can let me know if you have any questions or if there's any wrong notes you think or anything such. So there's the violin parts, there's a trumpet part, viola, cello, and double bass. And if anyone has a piano as well, I think we had a couple of pianists writing, but so there's one empty bar before, or two empty bars before.
Robert, did you say to unmute our microphones?
No, to probably mute, yeah, because it'll be a complete mess, I think,
with
Zoom performances. Nothing against them, but it'll be a lot, everyone playing together with different delay. Yeah, so if we mute our microphones and play through once, just get through it. Sorry, I forgot to mute some of the parts. Sibelius doesn't know how to read harmonics. okay, so we're going to only play the supporting parts so that you get to have the melodies. Okay, here we go. Okay. I hope everyone found that okay. I saw most people playing. I think some of you were not playing. Was everything okay? Do you have the was the sheet music clear and all that?
Yeah, it wasn't loud enough, so I had to play really silently so I could hear one. Yeah, but
okay, other than that, it was fun. Okay. Nice. Well, I think most of us got through it. I couldn't play either because it's quiet and you'd have to listen to me then. And so I think most of you have seen the video instructions for how to record it, right? And a bunch of you have already recorded, which is amazing. And so I thought I might just go over the instructions, because it's quite important to get it right. Because when we have so many people playing together and everyone's recording themselves separately, there'll be a wide range of things and the videos will have very different looks, but it's important that they have a kind of a unifying quality, and that they at least that the lighting is good, and that you can see yourself clearly, and then that the kind of quality matches the other videos. So it's not that someone stands out because they have a bad lighting situation like me. this is the worst lighting, actually. You shouldn't do like this, but if the view is amazing, then it might be worth it. But yeah, so let me just get up the video instructions. Where did I write them down? Okay, so yeah, find a good and or interesting background. So this is a important one, because yeah, you have to make it look good. And interesting background meaning sort of maybe if you're in your country, maybe it's in the nature, maybe there's some nice wall in your house where you have all the music or instruments and stuff like that. It can be anything. There's really, it's kind of up to you. And yeah, record your video horizontally. So we have it all like this. Not the selfie style, so that they can stack nicely. And when we edit there, they kind of have a similar format.
Is there a deadline for the video?
For the video, I would say it'd be amazing to have them by the end of the week, because
okay.
Then we have a deadline for when it has to be out, and that is in a week on Friday. And
okay.
And these kind of videos can be a bit of a tricky one to edit, because there's so many separate files. And what I will do is actually, you will all be recording this, you know, playing together as an orchestra. Essentially, you're all playing the same parts, but I might do little cuts here and there where one of you has the melody, then the next person has the melody, rather than you all playing at the same time. Because also not being in the same room, often what you get is that things like little nuances in the phrasing or the intonation or anything, any little thing, it won't be like in an orchestra. So everyone will be very unique, and it's great in a solo thing, but when you put it together as an orchestra, it doesn't always work. So it'll be a very creative process of putting it together and finding what works. And that's why it's sort of, you cannot predict the outcome of this, and we just need to see how it goes. So have the camera far enough so that your instrument's fully visible in the video. Yeah, so it also helps for us when we're editing it that we can cut something off so there's extra space and we can see you, so that when you record it, it's all nice and clear. We can see who you are, what you play. And yeah, and also one thing I noticed, if you can have the camera higher up, or at least at the height of your head, because if it's filming from below, you can often just see like unusual parts of the violin, and it's just generally, yeah, everything looks better if it's from a head height. So if you have like a music stand, you can put it on there, or like ideally if you have a tripod, something like this. I mean, I don't think anyone is as specialized as me. I have all these tripods and stuff, But if you have anything like that, or just a wardrobe, put it on there. And yeah, it's always worth also getting some gear, getting like something simple, like a tripod for a musician in this day and age is so useful. And it costs almost nothing. It's a couple of pounds, and it really improves your life quality on Zoom. Okay, and yeah, so there's a guide track. So what you heard when I was playing the Sibelius file, essentially that is available on the Google Drive, which I sent you in an email. And there is one with me playing two violin parts. But if you're not into that, there's also one without me playing the two violin parts, where it's just the piano and double bass. So you can play along that. And yeah, so you'll need to listen to the guide track while you're recording. That's very important, because that's the only way to play together. And the guide track has to be going through headphones. So you'll need headphones where you have like, you can put one ear on and one off, so you can still hear yourself. And you can hear the guide track at the same time. Does everyone have the tools for that, headphones and the two devices, because you will need to film it with your phone and probably play it on your computer with the headphones. So yeah, that's, I mean, sorry, some of you already heard this on Wednesday. I'm sorry. I'm just recapping. And yeah, if you have any questions about any of these technical things, please let me know, because it's better to just ask. And then I'll quickly answer you. Then, you know, you recording it and then turns out you wish you had asked and something was wrong.
And you wrote in the email that for the cellist it can be vertically as well. So
actually, yeah, I did mention that. Sorry. Yeah, for cello is one instrument where it definitely makes sense to have vertical, unless you can manage it horizontally. So it depends on how big your room is, essentially. Sorry, my headphone broke. Okay. So does anyone have any questions about the part of recording the music, the actual music, and following the guide track and doing all that?
Hey, Robert, yeah. If we have a kind of like a studio setting and we have a microphone we can record with, do you prefer the sound to be drier instead of like having a reverb, and then you just add the reverb later?
If you have the gear, I think do it just the raw signal, because besides me editing the video, I'll actually, the first big thing will be taking all of your sound, everyone's sound, and putting it together and mixing it, and we'll see how it's going, because again, it's coming from, you know, 30 different sources, so it will sound very, it will be very varied. So I'll be mixing it together, I'll be cutting it down. So if you don't add anything on top of it, that'd be great, because I'll probably be adding something anyway.
Okay.
To make it sound like Berlin Phil, basically. And that's the plan. And we actually have some of them here. I'm in Cēsis, it's a town in Latvia. And my sister is performing together with Bensel Fuchs. He's the first clarinetist of Berlin Phil, and they have the Karajan Academy there for young musicians. And some of the graduates are here, so they're all in the building. I might ask them to record something if there is a moment, and see if we can add that as well.
Great.
Yeah. So any other questions about recording?
Maybe
yeah.
Joy.
Verena, yeah.
How do we tune? Do we tune in 440/442?
Yeah, that's I was thinking about that, and I'm not sure if it will matter in the end, because it will be so many different instruments anyway. But I would say maybe 441. But you know, some people have already submitted, and I didn't really look, because if you listen to the guide track and if you play with the guide track, I don't know what it is. It's probably 440 in Sibelius. If you play with that and you listen to it, you just try and adjust to that, whatever it is, and try and catch me as well if you listen to the guide track with my recorded parts. And sorry, Elisabetta, were you saying something?
No, I was just saying, I see Joy has raised the
hand. Joy.
Yeah, I was just gonna say, I'm on my flute, which can be a little bit, sometimes, I haven't got a great mic, that's the other thing. Or I have, but I've still got to sort of set it up. But I have got Audacity, so that means I could record it just raw, and then I could just tidy up a little bit. That's not adding anything, but it's just tidying up any background or getting rid of any sort of noise and stuff.
Sure.
Would that help you, or should I just send it as it is?
I think, don't worry about it, because I'll be doing this anyway. I don't want you to spend extra time on that, because I'll be kind of going through all of that. I'll first tidy sound up, and then I will group it up, and I'll mix it. I'll add reverb. I'll add some Berlin fill and whatnot. So it'll all be fine. Yeah, don't worry. And I don't know for flute. I don't know the mic situation. I've never done that. Maybe distance helps. I don't know, or it doesn't. I don't know. It'll be up to you. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not too sure, because sometimes it just sounds a bit breathy. You know, it just sounds. And also, as I said, I've not got a great setup here. I mean, obviously, you can close the door, you can close the curtains. That's the other thing as well. People can do close the doors, close the curtains, get the sound around you as better as possible.
Sure.
But
yeah,
just get more of a studio feel. But it's just based, you know.
Yeah, I mean, the beauty of this is that it is not going to be a professional recording, and I think we can embrace that, because you know we're here in the middle of summer having fun. We should be on the beach, but we're here playing, and that's what we want to do. And I think it can mean more than a super high quality audio with fancy mics and things. If we have the energy and you know, if we also show it in the video, if we're really excited, if we're smiley and energetic, I think that definitely helps. So any other tech questions before I move on?
Does it matter in what violin position I play? Can I just play as it comfortable to me?
Yeah. What do you mean by the fingerings?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, please do as is comfortable for you. I didn't write anything in, and don't necessarily follow what I do. I just try to be very neutral in the guide track when I recorded. Yeah, so I stayed very low. I stayed on the first position mostly. Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, great. So I wanted to kind of move on a bit to the creating a storyline for this video, because just having us playing is one thing, and that's, I feel like that's been done a lot, and there have been people who've done it incredibly well, and it's huge amounts of people, and it's, you know, choreographed and whatnot, but I feel it can sometimes lack some kind of something else as well. So I thought, since this is, you know, Sistema, this is Europe, we're all from different places and have different lives. I don't know, we're not even in Europe all, I think we're all over the world. So if we can go out and take little bits of footage from, you know, our town, our city, or something that you think is interesting, and just kind of make a little clip and just send it. Don't worry too much about it being cinematic or anything. I think I'll take care of that. I'll see what we have and work with that. And also, I don't know if how many of you have seen stuff that I've edited, but I often like to create transitions, which can be quite quick and complex. But I mean, I'm sure you've all seen stuff on TikTok where they do kind of hit camera and all kind of things happen, and then you change from one thing to another. So I think we could really incorporate that, because it's a very simple concept, but it can kind of elevate a video and make it look cool. I think for transitions. So I'll send you all of this in writing as well. But And if you have any ideas as well, please do shout out and let me know, because this is a collaborative effort and I want everyone to be involved. But yeah, I thought if we do a little bit of filming around your surroundings, your town, some beautiful places, or, you know, the city center, I don't know what your situation is, but and then to have this kind of transition in another part of the video, I thought we could take the camera in our right hand. I'll send you all of this, but so when you're in your beauty spot or your city center or your mother's house, I don't know, anywhere, that you film yourself. Can you see? You won't be able to see. But if you film yourself, I'll send you like a little sample. And if it's a scenic spot where you do like a spin around, yeah, and then also you have some footage from just a normal camera. You don't need to be in it. You just take some shots of your surroundings, and maybe I'll put something else in there as well. I'll send you examples of all of that. So this is kind of, once you've recorded the music, you can, you know, look at this and. Yeah,
I will trust my mom to record.
you can do that. It's totally free and you can go crazy. I think we kind of need to get the energy to show and shine through the video, as we would if we were playing live and to an audience, which is so sad that we can't do it. But you know. I'll find all of you and we'll put together an orchestra. So does anyone have any other, you know, ideas for videos, or have you seen something cool that caught your attention? Oh, we have a question from Joy. Do we have a color scheme of things to wear? Oh, that's a really good one. So no, but I guess colorful would be good. Just generally, just, yeah. Wear crazy things. Yeah, I've just traveled to Latvia with a small backpack. I think, I don't know, what's the most extreme thing I have? Probably like a lightly pink shirt. But yeah, let's wear something bright. If you already filmed your video, don't worry. Or if you already wore something bright, that's great. Yeah, so let's see. What should we do? Do you guys want to... Should we go over some of the music again? Just, you want to play along? I can try and make it louder, and I want to play along as well. Maybe we can all play together. And you let me know if it works, because I cannot hear how it sounds to you, and Zoom can mess things up sometimes. But what we didn't do last time was I wanted to have us look at the sheet music while listening to the original song and playing along, because that's where you can really get to the real essence of the song, because you're not just reading music and listening to Sibelius, you're actually listening to the artist and what she intended with it. So do you all have your own sheet music that you can read? Yeah, or from the computer or anything? Okay, so I'm going to play the song on Spotify again, and the intro is a bit different than in the sheet music, but you'll hear when the piano starts playing. Let me just turn this. Okay, oh gosh, I am so bad with Zoom. Here we go. And I can play along, I think I can play along. Can you tell me if, because I will share my sound and then I'll mute my microphone because I want to play as well. And it might disappear when I mute my microphone. So I'm going to play the song now. Don't need to play yet. So, and now I'm going to mute my microphone. Can you still hear the song?
I got my driver's license last week.
Okay, so. Everyone ready? Let me just see, the Spotify is ready. It's loaded. And everyone's got their music. I hope my arrangement is exactly like the original song. I think I made it right, but let's hope for the best. Fingers crossed. Okay. 3, 2, 1.
Got my driver's license last week, just like we always talked about. Cause you were so excited for me to finally drive up to your house. But today I drove through the suburbs, crying cause you weren't around. And you're probably with that blonde girl who always made me doubt. She's so much older than me. She's everything I'm insecure about. Yet today I drove through the suburbs, cause how could I ever love someone else? And I know we weren't perfect, but I've never felt this way for no one. And I just can't imagine forever. Now I drive alone past your street, and all my friends are tired of hearing how much I miss you, but I kind of feel sorry for them, cause they'll never know you the way that I do. Yet today I drove through the suburbs and pictured I was driving.
Well done, everyone. You
that was amazing. Great, Luke. Really. Bravo.
Hey, actually, that could be useful footage. Like, since we're recording this workshop, you know, we can use some of that. And I hope you all looked very committed and into it. No, that was fun. So I don't know about you, but when I play listening to this instead of the guide track, I don't know, the sound is completely different. So, you know how when I'm just looking at the music, I might go something like, think that's a lot of, that's a very classical approach, but now when I was listening, I'm like, like all these kind of transitioning sounds that kind of are really bad in classical music can now come out. And if you want to do glisses and things in between, or, you know, go crazy. Yeah, feel free to be free and kind of forget about everything that was taught at school. Just enjoy the music. And but you do have to record listening to my guide track, not to Olivia. Because I told this to the workshop on Wednesday already, because what happens when people listen to original songs and like a full orchestral sound or full pop song, and then they play along, they, you know, you feel like you're part of it, you're having fun. But what happens is that you think you're part of this big thing, mm-hmm. so you don't really have to work so hard. And what is being recorded is only your voice. So if you then listen back to it and you're like, you thought you're being amazing and then you couldn't hear yourself, you're like, it's like when someone sings together on earphones and super loud, and then it sounds, they're having a great time, and then the people around them are like, what are you singing? And so that's why we have to listen to a click track or a guide track, so we can hear ourselves. And so we have to create this kind of the whole atmosphere and everything. We can't just surf on top of the existing song. Yes. What else did I want to say? Yeah, there's a lot of percussion sounds. I think, sorry, I'm there's like three levels of this recording this. But I think if some of you are open to it, I think maybe the people who already send their recordings as well, because you have done the, you know, the main part of it. If you're up for discovering, or if anyone else also is open to discover kind of some percussion sounds, I'll put together a little score, like a very simple thing. You don't have to play the whole song with percussion, like hitting your violin or whatever. It can be any kind of sounds, you know? I think there's like... So if there's only like a little clip of that of say 15 seconds, 20 seconds, that can be more than enough in such a video where there's so many of us and we kind of support each other. So if you're up for that, maybe give me a thumbs up and I will find you and I'll get those percussion sounds. So we have Rachel, we have Verena, because this is going the extra mile, so be ready. So Verena, Rachel, who else? We have Jose, we have Pipa, hello. Okay, so we have a full drum section. Oh, we have Gasel. Yeah. Was that a thumbs up? Yes.
Me too. Luke.
Luke. Where's Luke? There. Yeah. Hey, sorry. Okay. Percussions, and I mean I'll probably send the email to everyone, but just you guys, I'll go specifically for those extra sounds, because you can hear them. They, I think, mainly in the kind of climax section. Let me just show. Can you hear my sound? No, you don't. I think someone has a unmuted microphone situation. I don't know who it is. I can't see. And where is this coming from? Okay. So still see forever now. I drive alone past your. So listen to the percussion. Red lights, stop signs. I still see your face in the white cars. Front lights, can't drive past the. You know what? I think there's a good opportunity for a good old clap for everyone. In their, I think just in the video that you, when you finish your recording your video, just do like a few overly enthusiastic claps. And don't worry, you won't be alone. So if there's, you know, if there's 20 of you doing it, it looks okay. If I won't leave just one of you. I'll also put that in an email. Let me make a note. Get everyone to clap. That's good. And so some of those percussion sounds. Let's just hear. Places we used to go to, 'cause I still fucking love you, babe. Okay, so I think there's a lot to discover there, especially for string players. I mean, from my perspective, there's so much percussion to be done on the violin. I don't know if anyone has seen my arrangements, I always try and find new ways of adding rhythm to things because it kind of livens everything up. So yeah, feel free to experiment and I'll be writing you a message with percussion, about percussion. Okay, so yeah, hello, wait.
Well, hey Ramesh, I have a quick question.
Yeah.
So a bit earlier you talked about adding those extra sounds, doing those glisses. How do you strike a balance between doing that and fitting in as a section? So I guess maybe like in classical music, slides are kind of like maybe kind of avoided because it's hard to blend in as as a group of violins when you do that a lot. So I guess for this one, do you want us to have like total freedom and just do whatever you want, or just at least keep in mind having some balance?
So yeah, I mean that's the $1 million question. I think you can maybe don't go completely crazy, but if you do, it'll still be fine because, I am going to go through everything and I'm going to make it work one way or another. There's no other option. But if you go too crazy and I can't use some of it, I might need to basically shush you for a bit and then put you back in where it blends. I'll see how it works, but I think having little glisses and being free, it won't really mess anything up. Because this kind of freedom doesn't affect too much the rhythm. It's kind of like a different vibe, basically. It's as if, you wouldn't sing rock and roll with a choral voice. You wouldn't just... So you need to have a different voice for your instrument as well. And I think one person who can go well, Rob, are you the pianist? Yes. So we have a pianist. I don't think there's another pianist. I think someone wrote to me.
Oh, the pressure's on.
That was a pianist, but I think you are the one here.
Okay.
So if you feel like, because the piano part is very simple, so if you feel like adding things or adding arpeggios, I don't know, you might be incredible. So you can just improvise.
Yeah, I can probably add some bigger voicings to chords and things like that, but it's a good, I'll follow the guide, of course, but
for sure.
No, yeah. Maybe certain chords will be bigger.
Yeah, great. Yeah, because there's I think there's enough space for all of us to find our slots. Even like, Joy, you're playing, you're the only flute player, so you can go off the score as well a bit. And yeah, because you'll stand out anyway, just because the being the only flute. And then we have one trumpet player, Berwin. And I think a lot of us are just good old string players, which is okay. It's okay to play strings. does anyone have any questions? I think there's been quite a lot that I've just been talking.
You said videos by the end of the week. Is that like this weekend?
Yeah, so ideally, if I could have at least the main bit of you playing with the guide track, if that could be done before the end of the week, is that okay for everyone? Is that I know some of you, like people who were here Wednesday, I think there were at least 5 submissions already on Thursday, so it seems like, and they were great, I watched them. Thank you guys. And so I think it should be okay, quite manageable by the end of the week. And then we need to also see the extra footage, the footage outside or the transition footage. And I'll try and explain it as clearly as I can in an email as well. and give you some examples, because you know, if I'm not doing it, then you won't want to do it either. So I'm gonna embarrass myself and make some videos and show you, so you can follow suit. Yeah. Any other questions? I think we're all clear.
Let's try this.
So. Oh, Joy. Hey, Joy. Yeah.
Yeah, this is a bit off the chart, but I thought I might check it out if anyone wants to give it a go. I don't know if anyone's ever tried playing their instrument to an animal, because look on YouTube. You know those pictures of people playing their violin to sheep, and all the sheep come, all the horses come.
Yeah.
I know I've got robins in my garden, so I might play a little bit of some of the theme. A few bits of it outside and set it up, because my robin comes to my hand and he might just like the music. I don't know. I mean, he might hate it, but
wow.
You've got cats or dogs that you want to just give it a go and just play maybe some of the one of the main bits of the melody. You know, they might hate it, but they might just, you know, get involved. It could be lovely.
Oh, that's a brilliant idea. Yeah, exactly. That's the kind of spirit I want. Thanks, Joy. That's if you have animals or siblings, you know, same thing, just play to them. And Berwin wrote, "My dog cries whenever I play trumpet." and Rob's French bulldog loves Olivia Rodrigo. Oh wow, there is a very great video of a dog hating a particular symphony, and so the trumpeter plays whatever scale he wants and the dog is just minding his own business, and then he plays this theme from it's like an unnerving theme from a symphony, and the dog just starts barking and runs away. So they definitely feel the music. Anyone else? Any questions? I hear someone talking.
It's quite funny.
Maybe we could film something in the car since the song is called Driver's License.
Yes.
So I thought maybe clapping in the car. I don't know. Just filming something, sitting in the car, driving around the city, maybe. I don't know.
For sure. No, I definitely. I mean, that was the first thing I thought as well. I didn't want to be responsible for anyone crashing. But if you can do it in a safe way, if you can, you know, if someone else is driving or you do a thing and maybe you have your instrument in the car. I mean, please, if you can do it in a safe way and I won't get sued and you won't get hurt. this driver's license. What else can we do? I mean, she talks a lot about suburbs. Who lives in suburbs? We have anyone in American suburbs? I think that's Rachel. So you're our designated suburb video operator. We want good footage of exactly what the suburb life is about. So I just want to make sure I answer any questions you have before we run out of time. So if you can think of anything, because then you'll just have to go out and film yourselves with a guide track with amazing lights and backgrounds and dogs and cats and in a car. So before you set out into the world, let me know if you have any questions.
So after this workshop today, do we get to be in a meeting with you again, or is this it?
So I think this is it. There's the presentation of the video, but you know, since I'll be working on it quite a lot in the next week, if anyone, like, there might be a case where we need to discuss something, so we can set up a quick Zoom or just communicate through emails, but you know, talking sometimes is quicker than emailing. So yeah, we'll see how it's going. I think it's especially with the extra footage, the non-playing footage, we might need to, if you're up for it, to just sometimes have a quick chat. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Well, Mina, you have such a beautiful background. Where are you? You're already doing the footage.
Yeah. Hello, everyone. I'm in Salden, Alto Adige, like Südtirol somewhere. I don't know, like in the mountains. It's like something like that. Wonderful view. Oh, wow. Yeah.
It's not just a Zoom background, right?
Yeah.
It actually moves with you.
Yeah.
Oh, brilliant. Like I don't know. I didn't think we'd finish early, but I feel like you guys are set and you're ready. You're ready to record. Are you ready to record? Do you have it all? Do you have the guide track? You have the links to the Google Drive in the email. And oh yes, so when you upload your video, you put it, there's a folder called video uploads, and I think many of you already managed to do it, so I think it's working.
I put the link here in the chat, so if
okay, thanks,
somebody doesn't have it.
I'm just doing the chat now. Put some autotune on the dog's cries and put it in the music. Hey, this guy knows what he's talking about. This is a viral idea. Okay, yeah, well, thank you all for joining. I think you will be creating something special, and I'm looking forward to listening to it all and editing it all and putting it together and showing you in a week's time. But before then, I need you to go out there and film your performance, film your surroundings, but just concentrate on the performance first, and then we can see, you know, the cherry on top. Yes, thank you all. I've been looking at your guys' footage. I feel like I know you so well now. I've been editing it, listening to it. It's been fun. Hey. Welcome.
Hello, how are you doing?
Good. Oh, nice to see you. Yeah. So you're so pink. So <Yeah. laughs> oh, great.
I'm trying to pretend it's summer. It's chucking it down with rain and here. It's I'm in Lincolnshire and it's throwing it down. It's like,
oh gosh. Oh wow. Well, hopefully it returns. Yeah, we had a nice few weeks, didn't we? Welcome everyone. I'm just trying to see who's here. Yes, we have all our stars from the video slowly arriving. Where are you guys? Where is everyone? So Joy is in Lincolnshire. Where are you guys? You can unmute and tell me, or you can write in the chat. Of course, I saw some of the footage that you guys sent, so I could try and guess. Chat, Hong Kong. Oh yes. I remember. I saw your footage. It was great. Now let's see. So should we wait for a few more people, or should we?
Yeah, maybe one more minute.
Get chatting. Hassan is in Athens. Yes, I remember. There was some beautiful spots there, and I've been to Athens a few times. It's a wonderful city. You get a bit of history, a bit of, I don't know, a bit of danger in Exarchia, and great Souvlaki. It's a bit of everything. Leah is in Finland in a summer cottage. Where is Leah? Oh, I don't see you. You don't have video. Wow. That's nice. Myanmar. Oh, Venezuela. Okay. And Luke is in a small town in the USA. Oh, wow. That's interesting, because I saw the videos you sent me, and I wasn't sure for each of you where it was. And I thought maybe to put little location tags in the video, but I didn't want to try and guess and guess wrong. Okay. Well, I'm in Latvia. I'm near the beach. It's supposed to be cold here, but these days it's nicer than London and many other places. So we get a 30 plus degrees in the summer and minus 30 in the winter. It's a perfect mix. So should we get going? I'm gonna just basically talk to you about the process of making this video and in general kind of encourage you to go out there and make your own arrangements and learn how to produce them, because it's pretty easy now. There's so many tools and so many possibilities that you should really take advantage of, you know, make the most of your computer and iPad and phone to really put your music out there. And yeah, so let me share my screen and I'm going to show you the sound file for this project. I won't play it to you yet. I will save that for a bit later, but I'll just show you how it looks so you get an idea of what the behind the stages, behind the scenes looks like, and what me and Sam, who I don't know if you joined, but me and Sam have been doing over the last few days. It's been quite crazy. A lot of footage. Okay, so I'm going to share the Logic Pro file with you. So can you see this? So here is all yes. all the tracks. You can just maybe take a moment and try and see if you can figure out what's happening there before I explain. Is it big enough? I don't know if I can zoom in.
Yeah, we can see.
Okay. So let me just hide this. Okay. So this is Logic Pro. It doesn't always look this busy or scary. It's essentially, you can record anything here and just, you know, press record. And then you can record your songs here. You can put things in and edit them, which is what I did, because I didn't record anything here. I took all your videos and I extracted the audio of them and I put them here and I grouped us all. Here's our first violins. What color is that? Is that purple? It's kind of purple. So these are our first violins. Here are red are the second violins. Here we have two violas and a single cello, a flute, trumpet, bassoon, and this is Sam on the bass. And up here, I had the Sibelius track, the guide track that you all recorded to. And I just had it there as a kind of a the skeleton of everything. So I can synchronize it, your footage to this. So because we had the four harmonics in the beginning, which I put in every part, I could see where you started. So even if you were going super free later on in the piece, I could still see where you started, and so I can put you all together and it doesn't fall apart. And up here is the original song, because I wanted to also see, I was considering adding it also in the mix, just very, very low in the background, but I didn't because you guys were so good. We didn't even need that. We have the original track here, but I realized that it was actually like 4 beats per minute faster than what we were recording. And that's kind of a problem because it wouldn't line up nicely. But luckily for me, I've done quite a bit on the software and there's a way you can just, I mean, this is a whole, so can you see the whole screen or are you seeing the Zoom thing?
Yeah, the whole screen.
Okay, okay, good. So what I did was there's this thing called flex time. You see here, I can edit the timing of things, and I took the whole song and I kind of squashed it a little bit. So you can't hear anything different in the song other than that it's a little bit slower. And this was one of the tools that actually I use in a couple of places for our playing, because, you know, since there are so many of us playing the solo line, the melody line at different points, it was inevitable that we would have places where we're not together, or places where, you know, something just falls out of sync. So that's when I also took like this rhythm tool, and I, you know, I could just push one little note like half a second one way or the other. And I can, maybe I can show you a little example. I'll need to make sure that you can hear it. So I'll make myself solo here and output device, Zoom audio device. Tell me if you can hear this. Because I can't hear that. Can you hear that? Well, nobody can hear that. That's not very good. Wait, maybe this has to be here as well. I swear this, it changed. I swear people in Zoom, they change this every time just to mess with me. It's different setting every time. Let's try something else. Zoom loopback. Just a second. More. I'll share it again with my sound. Okay, let's see now.
I hear it.
You can hear me, right? So that's just my part here. So I can show you the kind of things you can do with this. It's very fun. So let's see. Let's hear how this. I think that's enough. So now I will get the timing and I can mess with it. I don't know how good this will sound. I mean, that's not very useful, like what I did now, but it just kind of shows you what it is. So sometimes when someone entered too soon or hung on too long onto a note, so I did a little bit of this kind of tidying up. And all this is kind of the step one of, you know, getting this together and putting it together. So you have to have the sound before you can build the video, really, because if I'm going to have one of you on the screen, I want to also hear you. And it's a very slow process, because you have to make decisions early on before you even have the video. You kind of have to just make decisions all the time. So like the tiniest thing you'll have to already figure out before you even get to the video. Okay, so then what I did was I grouped all of us together in sections, which you can see here. Yes, and I synchronized and I changed the timings and I tidied any sounds where someone dropped something or anything like that. And I picked the solos and I picked kind of so everyone has their moment, and so it still sounds like a section, but so you can hear that one of the persons playing a bit clearer and louder. So they're at the forefront. So you can see here how that changes here. And this is where everyone comes together and we have a big tutti section throughout the B section and the chorus of the song. can have a little listen. Let's just hear the violin one, for example. Whoops, not there. Hey, actually, before I don't want to mess up that one bar that I did. I want to make sure I'm... Okay, it's fine, I think. Okay, let's hear just the violins. Violin one, for example, in... So, I mean, it's kind of this intense sound and everyone's playing unison. It's kind of actually how an orchestral section sounds as well. And I'm quite happy with this because you get a ring, which is, you know, when you get like 20 violinists playing the same thing, you get these weird undertones. I don't think it's overtones, but it's like just a mass of sound in an orchestra. And if you're in a section, you can feel it sometimes if everyone's playing well and in tune. You kind of these like almost bass notes that are created by the different timbres of the violin. It's freaky, but yeah, so you can hear that here. Okay, and so over here, I did some... This is EQ. So here you can change the timbre of the sound. So this is, I may have done like a little tweaking for individual sounds. And here, this is the section. Here's the section. So you can, I hope you can hear the difference on the headphones. I'm gonna just show you what it does roughly. So you can hear, these are all the frequencies, and you can change it and kind of mold it as you wish. Hope I can get, oh, I can't get it back in place. But so this is where I gave some of the high register for us, and a little bit of the lower register as well, which is where those undertones might be, and kind of a more bassy sound for when we go lower in the violin. And yeah, then we added compressor, which is something you wouldn't use in classical music much, because it basically kind of gets rid of dynamics to an extent, but you can control how much it does it. But since we're playing a pop song, we basically had to use compressor, because in a pop song, it is, if you look at a pop song on a kind of a, just the audio file, throughout the whole thing, it will be max volume. Like they will compress it so it's always equally loud, and it's the maximum punch you can get for it, and basically that it works on radio, and it's kind of, people want to dance to it, and it's always stays loud. That's basically kind of the pop world. But in classical music, you generally want as wide range of dynamics as possible. But here, yeah, I compress the sound a bit, which also helps it sound more like a section rather than 10 or 12 individuals. And lastly, I added some reverb here. Let's have a listen to it with reverb and without. This is with reverb, and this is without. And with. So it's not too much, but it adds some kind of sense, like we might all be in the same place. And since we're recording in our homes, I just added it like kind of a room reverb, large wooden room. And yes, so that's the first violin section. I definitely spend the most time on first and second violins, because just there's so many of us doubling, and it kind of, that is what can create a lot of the trouble, and also, you know, the most rewarding sections, because you can really mold them and create something out of them if you have the numbers there. And it's a similar story to the second violins. We have the some effects applied, and yes, we can hear the seconds also. Let's have a listen. I think they have the melody here. Together, let's have all the violins. Let's have a listen. I don't know if how well Zoom transmits the audio and whether you have headphones, but I also put the first violins are slightly on the left, like you would in an orchestra, and the seconds are slightly to the right. Look, you can control it here. This is I just wanted to create a bit of an image, even though we're all in the sort of same, in the center of camera, but still, so we can imagine we're in an orchestra concert. Can you hear that? Yes, you have the stereo, okay. Okay, so then we have the lower strings. We can see those guys. Okay, and we have our bass. This is Sam. And the thing with the putting this together that's tricky is you never know what people, what device people will be listening on. So it could be someone listening with a professional set of speakers on their home computer, or it could be someone sitting on the toilet watching on their smartphone. Like, you cannot know what it's going to be. So you have to try and make it work on everything. So there's this kind of general thing that, for example, the bass has to sound good on a phone, and the phone doesn't really have much bass in itself. It doesn't have the speakers or the size that you need to produce it. So you kind of have to play around with the equalizer here with the frequencies. And I've probably done a bad job here because that's all the high frequencies that I've taken out. But so for the smartphone, you'd need to have a stronger presence in this kind of range, so you can have that, because if you hear the high frequencies of a low note, you can still imagine the bass note. It's sort of like a ghost note. If you play all the harmonics of a really low note, you can actually, it tricks your mind and you can still hear it, and as if it was there, even if your computer or your phone is incapable of producing that sound. Okay, so we have our strings, and here we have our wind and brass section, which is three people. We did definitely had a bigger turnout on the violins here this year. But, you can have a listen. Brilliant. That could be a new chamber piece. We'll consider transcribing it. Yes, so that was all that you sent to me, guys, and you recorded it to this uninspiring Sibelius click track. So good job, everyone. I'm very pleased with how it's turned out. And yes, I can't wait to share it with you, but I think I should wait a bit more. I want to tell you a bit about the video editing process as well, but I don't want to show it to you yet. So let me just see what we have. So this is the sound file. This is the whole thing. This is the mixing stage of it. What I had to do afterwards was export it all to a single sound file. I think this is it. Close. Oops. Here we go. So what I did then was export it here. So that's all the sound together. And here I also added some effects. I haven't saved that, so it's not here. But here you can see I added some reverb also to the entire thing to kind of unify the sound. Because if you have something like 8 different parts or 10 different parts and they each have their own sound and reverb, then it won't sound united. So what you do now in this stage of it is you kind of apply some effects to the whole orchestra and you create the final sound and sort of basically blend it into one from, you know, 20 different tracks. So I added some more reverb here, and I also, this is the stage where you add some more of the kind of audio visualizing techniques. This is, so here you can add something like this direction mixer, which is where you can spread the sound out and narrow it down. This is kind of how big the sound kind of looks without your ears. Like if you're just listening, you can hear the space. If you put it all the way, it sounds like it's really wide and far away. And if you put it here, it sounds like it's right in your forehead, basically. So that's, I don't think we'll hear that difference on Zoom. So I'm not going to demonstrate, but, and in the end, then you add some compression as well, which is important for kind of having that equal dynamic throughout the song, even though it won't be like a real pop song where you see this would be, the whole thing would be like maxed out like this. You have it super loud all the time. So, but in this case, we do a little bit of that. So we get some of that compressor. And we compress the dynamics, and now we can see how it works. So let me just show. You can see this line. This is, it's basically when it gets too loud, it suppresses the dynamics, and when it's too quiet, then it pulls it up. It kind of does it on its own, and it's quite interesting, at least for me. Okay, so that was a little walk through the process, and yeah, I kind of wanted to show that side of things because I want all of you to kind of maybe consider playing pop music yourselves and maybe producing something yourselves, because it can be very easy. Even on your phones, on your iPhones, you can film something, you get an app and you put your sound and video together, and you can, you know, record a full song by playing different parts of it and then stitching them together. And you know, the world is waiting for it. You can just upload it to social media, see how it goes, and learn new things and discover new possibilities, which is certainly what happened to me when I kind of first started, sorry, I unplugged my headphones, which is what happened to me when I first started playing pop songs and kind of going out of the normal standard repertoire and kind of creating my own things. Also, another tool that might be useful for you is Sibelius, which is where you can write scores, where you can write things down. It is free and it's very easy to use. Here I wrote the whole score for everything, and then there's different parts for people. And yes, you should definitely check it out. It's a very kind of user-friendly piece of software, at least to get started. and you can have a free version. It doesn't cost anything. And, you know, write down your ideas. You can then develop them there. You can arrange things. You can create a good looking score. You can sell your arrangements. It can be all kinds of things. And yeah, it's basically the only way I write down music now. I don't use pen and paper anymore, which is kind of a shame, I guess, but you can easily share the scores with people like I did with you and make it look professional without too much effort. Okay, so I think I'm gonna show you the video now. I'll need to figure out a way first how to do it because I am not very good at Zoom. Let me just see. Okay, I have the video here. I think if I just share this window with you, that should work. Share sound. I'll double check that the sound will work. Sound. Okay. Scream at me and wave your arms if the sound's not there, because I don't want to ruin this first playthrough. Okay. Thank you. Okay.
Amazing.
Awesome.
Well done, everyone. Thanks for being a part of this. We still have the titles. Okay. Yes, so I will show you a little bit kind of behind the scenes of how we put it together, because it's always kind of a video editing can be a very messy process, but you know, when you've done it a few times and when people submit beautiful footage like you guys did, it really helps, because then you don't have to kind of run against the wind. You don't have to just try so hard and then there's nothing to work with. So it was really kind of a rewarding process, and I will show you a bit how the project looks. So let me see, let's share the, so this piece of software is Final Cut, but there is a Final Cut Pro, but there are many, many different softwares that are kind of similar and they all basically do the same thing. So here we have the whole film. Okay, it doesn't look like much until you actually scroll up and down. There's it's a whole thing. Sorry, this is a so the actual editing actually isn't very hard, but it's most of the time you end up fighting with the software. So you kind of have to find one that works best for you, or that is the least terrible, more like that. And because there's always things that don't work, and some you move one thing and everything else moves along with it, and it's kind of just trial and error and seeing what works. Let me put this volume down. Okay, so let's see the beginning. So, sorry, my computer is a bit, okay. So actually, it's things like this that are the more complicated parts of it. So just making little transitions and stuff that should be simple actually turn out looking like you have to, you know, you have to adjust everything so it's in the right place. And this is quite a short one, but you can really get absorbed in creating transitions, because that's, you can do anything here, but it's just finding the right way and the easiest way to do it, because often you will encounter some limitation and then kind of have to abandon the whole thing. And there's just no, you know, there are some apps for this, but you know, you can't edit the whole thing on an app. So you have to kind of learn how to use something like this. And I think a simple version for Mac is iMovie. And I'm sure there's also other free things for Windows that you can use and look into, or even on your iPads or phones. You know, you can even edit a video on TikTok if you want, inside the app. I think that's actually what they expect you to do on TikTok, but I haven't done that. So I was responsible for putting together the first half of the footage. And then from Chorus, I let Sam take over. And that's where you also have the big shots. And that's why it was kind of possible to do this in quite a short time, because some of your footage arrived, I think, on Tuesday or Wednesday. And we put it together basically yesterday. For one person, it would be pretty impossible. So these things can take time. But yeah, let's see. Is there? So here, everything that is, things that are at the top are what you see, basically. So you have to have some kind of order here. So you can always free little bits of space to let other people through here. There's always something behind everything else, and it's like a stack of things, and you only see the top layer. And we tried many different edits, and we kind of shared them and see what works, and pairing different instruments together and here putting the, you know, to so it reflects what you hear as well in the video. So you have a kind of a, so the whole edit reflects the music. And that's why a lot of the cuts are happening in rhythm. And that is why I wanted also Sam to help me, because Sam is a musician, a professional musician. And if I could have got a video editor to help me, but if they don't have a understanding of orchestral instruments or the music, and you know, even simple things like having the bow stroke for every violinist together, you know, it's not simple for non-musicians. They will look at it and think, oh, that's great. But actually, if a violinist looks at it, it'll be like, that's terrible, that's 2 seconds out, and it looks nothing like it should. And so basically that was a big part of also, you know, synchronizing everything. And I don't know if any of you noticed, but we cut out a part in the middle, because so the song would be more manageable for listening, for watching, because, you know, attention span online is not that long. And while we couldn't fit it in 12 seconds, we did try our best, and it was 3 minutes. But yes, so yeah, here's the video. Here's how it looks from the perspective of putting it together. It can be messy, but it's kind of a fun process. And I would recommend for you guys to kind of maybe just watch some YouTube video on how to use this software, because it's really, it's trial and error. You have to have a go at it and play around and see what works. It's definitely a really good skill to have, because you know, all social media and everything is video oriented now. And if you are able to make nice videos and you can create something fun and cool looking, it will definitely help you. And if not just for your own playing and career, it might be useful, you know, to do sometimes to help someone else with editing. And it's a very high value skill, I think. And you can get really creative with it. It's not even about just being the most knowledgeable or being the best editor or having the most amazing computer. It's also about telling a story and kind of putting together footage in your own unique way and trying to convey the message that you have. So it's not just, you know, we could have just had 24, 23 different people playing all the time. And so that's why we had also the extra footage, which you can't see here. It's in the second half. So that's where we put in some of the more personal moments from where you all living, where you all live, and what kind of places you come from, and how this whole project's brought us together, and yeah, kind of attach it a bit of a story. Well, more or less, that's basically what I've been doing, and that's what it looks like, and I'm sure we'll be published it on SEO pages.
Yeah, of course. And I was wondering if maybe anyone has any questions. Maybe now it's a good moment to ask if you have other curiosities you want to ask Robert.
Yes, I would like to ask.
Hello.
Yes, hello. It was really fantastic. Thank you for this work. How did it feel like doing putting up this this video and working with all these participants?
Well, it was actually amazing, because I've done projects like this before, and sometimes you don't get the kind of energy that these guys had, and everyone sent in their footage. Everyone looked great and happy in it, and you guys also sent the extra footage from where you are, and kind of you know, to be extroverted for it. You know, you can't, because then it's much easier to create the video if everyone kind of puts their best in, and you have great footage to work with. Yeah.
Okay. And will this go also to YouTube or?
Yes, I think that's up to Elisabetta. I'm not sure where exactly.
I think now we will sort it out, but I think we will publish this video on SEO's channels So for sure on Facebook, probably on Instagram, so that then you, Robert, can you, you can share, you can see it on our channel. And I don't know if also, tell me if it's a good idea, we transfer maybe?
We transfer.
Only to the participants, of course.
Yeah, we'll put it in the Google Drive, same place where everyone uploaded their things. And we'll leave it there if any of you want to put it on your TV and leave it running all day or something.
Okay. Actually, I have a request. We have maybe 15 minutes free before the last session of SEIO. So I was wondering if we can watch the video again. I know you hate me, Roberts, because you have seen this video 1 million times, but I really like it. So if you can share it again, I will be happy.
I'm happy to watch it again.
Other participants, so.
It's easy to watch it from this side of the edit. You know, once it's done, it's fun. while you're working on it, it can be tiring. But this was actually very enjoyable. Okay, I'm going to share the screen.
Thank you.
Nice.
Thank you. And bravo to everyone again. Really.
Yes, bravo everyone.
Good job, everyone.
Yay. Oh, I'm trying to see.
So I don't see everybody clapping.
No, no.
Everybody. We physically clap.
Muted clap.
No, no, real.
That's it.
Thank you.
Thank you
perfect,
all.
Perfect, perfect. What an adventure. Thank you so much.
Indeed. So, let's see if we can repeat it in person another year.
Yes, 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 yes. Let's aim for that. Thank you, Robert.
Absolutely.
And for being really, really present in this and guiding us through it.
It's been fun.
And thank you to the team who was extremely responsible, Elisabetta, Mina, always on the ball. Thank you so much. And Sasha, who is sometimes disconnected due to isolation, but not COVID isolation, but internet isolation. So everybody was on. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.